Hello guys, welcome to our live. So today we're painting trees. So I'm just going to stretch my paper so it won't move or bend. And today we were going to paint using gouache and watercolor. We're going to paint a quick bare tree to have like this autumn vibes, and we're going to paint an oak tree as well. Okay, great. Our paper now is stretched, and I'm just showing you my materials. This is my jelly gouache. Here is the palette. I always forget to clean them. I suppose it happens to most of us. So here is my clean jar of water. And here are my brushes. I have the black tulip, some Turner brushes, and I have the fine line user brushes. And I have my watercolors here from Art Supplies, the Allegro, and the Serena. And there is also the Prezioso. I haven't used it that much, but I really want to because it has like this very beautiful metallic shades. But I think they best look more visible against black paper rather than white. So we will use them sometime soon. So I'm just going to show you what they look like against the black paper. So we are ready to start. I'm just going to look for my fan brush, because maybe we're going to need it. It's from the Renoir set from Art Supplies. It's not really intended to be used with watercolor or gouache, but it's the only fan brush I can find at this moment. So I'm just taking it by my side and let's see what we can do with it. So, okay, we're just going to start from the oak tree. And I'm going to take my ring brush. Hope it's clean. Oh, and I'm going to need some. Oh, sorry. Some paper towel. Because you never know when you're going to need it. Okay, so I'm just gonna leave it there. And let's see. Here I have the Serena palette, and it has like all these beautiful tones. It has this very earthy tones, I'd say. All these browns, a lot of greens. So we're just going to take some brown And we're going to paint the line here. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight. It's fine. And it's going to be a little thicker here at the bottom. Awesome. So I'm just going to clean my brush. And I'm going to switch to, let's see, I'm just going to keep this here. And I'm looking for the round brush and the fine line miniature set. Number two round. Hello, John. So I'm just going to mix my colors here. I like this really nice emerald shade, and I'm going to mix it with a little bit of yellow ochre to have this really nice golden green color. And we're starting from the top. So at the top half of the tree, the branches and everything aren't that thick, so as we move down to the bottom, the branches become like larger and thicker. So I'm just making this sort of dabbing motion. I think it makes the drawing look more realistic. So as we go on later, when it dries, we're going to add a few more layers so it has like more depth, but right now I'm just making sure the tree has the right shape. This is like very quick and easy. It's really not that hard to paint trees. It just needs, you know, some observation and a little bit of practice. So here at the bottom, our tree is going to be more full. So I'm just going to let it dry a little bit and we will move back to it. So in the meantime, oops, it's okay. We're going to take some brown jelly gouache and we're going to paint the look. Of the pear tree. I think I'm going to take a bigger brush for this. I'm just gonna have the number one angle brush from the fine line ninja set. So gouache is like more opaque and thicker than watercolor. It also dries faster. And if you add some water on top, it will reactivate. So yeah, I think you should be careful not to add a lot of water when you do the layering, because that might ruin the previous layers. But you can also dilute it with a lot of water and have like this more watercolor effect. But I think that depends on your style and the subject. But mostly I think on your style. So we're just adding the first layer here. So I really like the angled brush because you can also paint easily straight lines and details, but also it allows me to fill in the drawing quickly. myself our dream, the first one. So I'm just mixing some blue to my green just to make it a bit darker. Let's try a little bit. The fun brush. Okay, definitely add some texture. Interesting. It's nice. So the foam brush is like very useful tool when you're painting trees. Especially when painting old trees. Because it adds all this texture and makes the tree way more realistic. And it's very, very easy to do. I think we need some highlights. So I'm just going to mix a little bit of white and green and yellow together. Thinking it's a little bit more white. Okay. just here and there. And we're going to paint some branches as well. So we're going to need again the throwing brush. That's nicer. And we're also going to add a little shadows at the bottom. Just faintly. Great. So let's go to finish off our other tree. Just mix our colors. Okay. And we're going to need some burnt sienna. To have this sort of mahogany color. We're going to need a little black and for the highlights. Okay, so it's always great to mix your colors before you paint because that really saves a lot of time. And I'm going to need my round brush. Also, another tip is not to leave your brushes too long in the water because that might affect the shape of the brush tip and it might ruin the brush, I mean the outer layer of paint. So the street is a little bit spooky, probably follows the Halloween vibe. I can't believe that tomorrow is like the 1st of October, I mean September went by so fast. also pretty excited. Because that means that Halloween and then Christmas is near, which is like very my top favorite holidays. So I'm looking forward to it. Hi, Laura. So we started by adding the darker values and now we're just going to light up the some parts. So tree has like more texture. so yeah, I think this tree looks very spooky, which I kind of like. And we're going to switch to the ringer brush and just paint these branches. Yeah, I think I really like this spooky tree. So it has like this also very scary roots. So this is it for today. I hope you have enjoyed watching, and I hope you find this tutorial very useful and easy, and I can't wait to see all the wonderful creations. And if you paint trees as well, don't forget to post it so I can see it. Thank you very much. Bye.